Conducting can be a very electrifying experience. It can be something that being very, very potent. There is a sense of having a sense of power over the music. You control a lot of the things, you have to make a lot of decisions about the music. But overall, the experience is incredibly engaging. You have such responsibility as a conductor that an awful lot has to factor in your head while you're doing it. The big challenges with conducting, the first is the score itself. Getting into the music is a big thing. It takes a lot of time. You have to go through it very methodically. You have to make a lot of decisions about how you want the music to sound, and then make decisions about how you're going to show how the sound is going to be produced by the musician. So you need to think intellectually, first of all, and then to think almost choreographically in how you could present your movements to the orchestra. Very similar to corporate life, and a lot of people have talked about this, you know, in these kind of international talks about, you know, leadership and business and music. With the organisation of the orchestra, you have different people fulfilling lots of different roles. You have a main person at the top, essentially, who is controlling everything, but they're very much a collaborative kind of person. They're not a dictator type person, as maybe it would have been a long time ago. And within the orchestra, you have lieutenants who kind of also take responsibility for the group. So you have section leaders, you have wind principals, brass principals, percussion players. They all take this responsibility. And there's also this idea of pulling together for the greater good. So there's a commonality of purpose with an orchestra. There are favourites. At the moment, I've been doing a lot of Beethoven symphonies, and they are wonderful pieces to conduct because they are so engaging for the conductor. You take so much responsibility for the physical nature and the physical feel and sound of the music that you really have to get your hands dirty. Other than that, I mean, I really enjoy doing the big kind of showcase 20th century pieces where you get fabulous orchestration and loads of different effects and great kind of crossing rhythms. But I think with something like the Beethoven symphonies are really good because you have to be very, very engaged in the music at a physical level. The conductor is doing a lot of things. I mean, the obvious one is controlling tempo, controlling speeds, controlling balance. But generally, it's giving a single vision to a piece of music, because with a large group of musicians, it's too difficult to negotiate an idea for all the people performing. So you need someone who's going to bring those ideas into one singular vision, and that's really what you're trying to do.